In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to easily create a liquid effect using standard effects. Hi, my name is Manuel. I'm a freelance motion designer. To follow along or play around, you might want to download the project file. Let's get started. I've already added a background solid with a gradient ramp. On top of that, I've added some text. My comp is 1920 wide and 1080 pixels high, by the way, and 60 frames long. Now let's grab the pen tool, make sure no solid is selected, and draw 4 liquid drops, spread somewhere over the type. You could use any kind of graphic objects in the background. I use type because it refracts nicely. Let's name the shape layer droplets. Fill in stroke wide. Let's set the stroke width to 1 pixel. Let's add an effect. We search for the 4 color gradient in the search bar over here on the right and drag it over into the effects window, changing colors. I go for white, a nice cyan, a bright purple, and a very bright yellow. Make sure it somehow fits to your color palette you use in your project. Let's move these points here a little to get a nice and soft gradient. Next, let's right-click on the shape layer and go to Layer Styles and select Bevel and Emboss. We change some settings: Style, Inner Bevel, Technique, Chisel Soft, Size 18, Soften 16. Highlight Mode, Multiply, let's change the highlight color into a bright purple. The shadow color into blue, and the opacity of both colors to 100%. Ooh, really ugly. Let's move on quickly. First of all, let's clean up. We move all 4 paths of our droplets layer into shape 1. And delete the 3 empty shapes. We only need 1 shape for all paths. Much simpler to work with. Now, we set the opacity of the fill of the remaining shape to 25%. Phew, much better already. As you can see here, the inner bevel adds this soft shade to the liquid, which gives it some depth. Then let's add one more effect. One of my favorites, turbulent displace. This adds more detail to the shape and some movement. Displacement, turbulent. Let's set the amount to 50, the size to around 46, and the complexity is 1. Now let's set a keyframe for the evolution here at the beginning, then move to the end and set it to 90 degrees. And very important, set the anti-aliasing to high for best quality. Now we need to add some refraction in order to make it look like more real. Therefore, we duplicate the droplet solid and name it droplets matte. We delete the gradient effect, make sure the fill and the stroke is wide, then set the opacity of the fill to 100%. We don't need any layer styles here. Next, we go into the shape here and open all paths and link them to those in the droplets layer. We grab the property pick whip right next to path 4 and drag it down onto the property of path 4 of the droplets layer. Path 3 to path 3 and so on. Then we close the content menus and go into effects. Open both turbulent displace effect settings and do the same thing. We link anything we might have to change later to the settings of the droplets layer turbulent displace effect. The amount, size, complexity, and evolution. We delete these keyframes here by simply clicking on that little stopwatch. All path animations and changes in settings in the droplets layer are taken over by the droplets matte layer. Next, we duplicate the matte layer one more time. Just check in, all links are taken over, which is great. Then we duplicate the type layer. Now let's move the droplets matte layer above the liquid layer. The droplets matte 2 layer above the liquid 2 layer. Let's hide these 2 layers for now. The matte 2 layer is the luma matte of the liquid 2 layer. That's our text inside the liquid. This matte layer down here is the luma inverted matte of the bottom text layer. As you can see, that's our type outside of the liquid. Now let's work on some refraction. We scale up the top type layer to around 105% and slightly move the position a few pixels to the right and down. Then let's add CC glass to the upper text layer. The droplets layer is our source. Change this to effects and masks, the property is luminance. Softness 5, height 56, displacement 110. We're using effect light, the intensity at least 100, and in shading, all lights full brightness for more contrast. Let's animate the paths of our droplets. Select the solid and go into the properties, open our paths and set a keyframe at 30 frames. Then we move to the beginning and make them very small. We select the first path, press Command T, T for transform, I guess, then drag one of these corners to the middle while holding Command and Shift. Finally, we change the form a little bit. Some faith that who gon' hurt this. I naughty night you lullaby. I'm doing me is doing. Then we select these keyframes back here and open the graph editor. Make sure the snap icon is activated and edit speed graph is selected. We grab this handle here, drag it down to the bottom line and at the same time to the left as far as possible. Then we select all left points and drag them down and to the left as far as possible as well. Awesome. One last thing though, maybe this small drop appears later, so let's move these keyframes to the right. One frame before it appears, we need to move the shape out of the screen and change the first keyframe into a toggle hold keyframe. Maybe one more. Why do you think I prefer a toggle hold keyframe here? Let me know in the comments below. Time for you guys to play and mess around with the effect settings. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell if you want to know exactly when the next video is coming out. Thanks so much for watching. Hope that tutorial was useful for y'all. See you next time, guys. Bye!